Hey, thanks for clicking on the extended version of my cast interviews for the new Disney film, Maleficent, Mistress of Evil. I can't believe what Angelina Jolie did in the first film. She cursed a baby. Well, she's back, and she has met her match. We are talking to three powerhouse actresses, Angelina Jolie, Michelle Pfeiffer, and Elle Fanning. But first, a quick look around. This is what they do sometimes at a film junket, especially for a Disney movie. They love giving us the opportunity to see some of the costumes worn in the film in person. And in this one, Angelina wears several. That's just one of them. Oh, back to the cast interviews. Take a look.
I remember the story of an evil witch. When I look out my window, and the princess she cursed to sleep forever. Many sights to see. The story became legend. But this is no fairy tale.
I need to start out with how nervous I am. I mean, I have to imagine that you all understand the effect you have on people like me. Can you sense it? Be honest.
Really, it always surprises me, honestly. Sometimes I think people don't like me and I walk away from an encounter and I think, God, did I offend them? I thought I was making an effort to, and then I forget. You know, that sometimes people get nervous.
I hate interviews. They make me very nervous.
Aww. That's a great way to start this.
Interviews.
I really don't want to be here.
Yeah, exactly.
I think the fun thing is nervous. We're all the same, right? In that we're all trying to, in this business and all on camera and all have that pressure to get that piece done and do it well. And so, in truth, we're all quietly rooting for you right now.
Thank you.
You know what I mean? That's how that's kind of what's really going on.
There are fairies missing from the moors.
What I'm missing is some wine.
Stolen by human poachers.
That's the first I've heard of it.
The dinner scene.
Yeah.
I mean, I felt uncomfortable. I was getting ready to leave because it was so tense in there. You all have been to many dinner parties. What is a dinner party don't?
I'm sure I've done it. Dinner party don't. I'm a terrible conversationalist, and especially I'm not good in those situations where I don't know people, and I am not good at small talk. I just don't go.
I just made a mental note, invite Michelle over for dinner.
No, I'm not going to be the one. It's like, oh yeah, they're great at a, you know, dinner. No, I'm not me.
Yeah.
Not me.
Yeah, I'm the same. I'm very straightforward, so it's impossible to not.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not good at.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it'll come out.
Being obedient.
I'm not good at being obedient.
And then if I have one glass of wine,
oh boy,
like anything will come out of my mouth. Anything.
So invite her over, but have the liquor flowing.
Yeah. Yes.
You have done an admirable job going against your own nature to raise this child. But now, she will finally get the love of a real mother.
I don't want to throw out the B word, but Michelle just takes it to a whole other level.
Yeah,
you know,
she's great.
She's amazing.
They're so good, you know. These are some of the best actors in the world. And they're playing iconic characters. Angelina Jolie, she puts on the horns, and you're at the movies, you know, even right in front of you. You know, so for a filmmaker, it's a dream. And then having, of course, Michelle Pfeiffer, probably one of the few that can actually go up against Maleficent.
What do they actually talk about? I mean, like when you say cut and everyone's setting up for the next shot, are they talking about kids and college and facial creams?
I don't really notice. I'm off to the next one. You know, so I never stand there hanging around hearing the small talk.
I guess you are busy.
Yeah. No, but they have tremendous respect for each other.
Prince Philip has asked Aurora if she'll become his.
Don't ruin my morning.
It's about goodbyes too. I mean, you're getting married and it's hard to say goodbye. I know you just went through this with college and you've been through it already. Advice to moms on dealing with saying goodbye to your kids, kind of letting them go a little bit and giving them space.
It's a new beginning.
And see, for everyone, including you.
It's right.
And this person you love so much is growing and becoming more of the person that you love. And and your world is actually expanding. It's not, you're not losing something. And just try to remember that when you miss them terribly.
And you remember that too, and your parents miss you.
Yeah.
It's gone crazy comedy.
I remember on the first one, Angelina talked about bumping into stuff with the horn. So how often did that happen with the two of you? Or did it?
My horns were 2 foot long. So I did have to be somewhat careful coming in. What we'd do is, you know, we'd be in the green room and we'd all be there just chilling out, having a coffee or whatever. And I'd come out And then I'd have to duck down underneath the doors to come in and such, and we'd have this whole process of putting them on just before we stepped on set. Sometimes with Angelina, we'd bump horns. I don't think we got in a tangle, did we?
No, I mean, it got down to kind of a fine art with my horns. They were sort of removable with a kind of, if you knew how to twist them, right, it was demagnetized at a certain twist, and then they'd come off kind of easily. And so it wasn't me, I wouldn't remember to do that, but people would come in after cut and just be like,
it's like a Formula One pit stop.
Exactly. Yeah. Maybe because of that. If you notice, Angelina's horns are part of a whole headpiece. So they're actually harder to get to take off. So maybe because of that, because of the bumping in from the first one, just bumping into things, you know, they were very alert to any movement from me.
You'd think it would have happened more though. Sometimes we had 40 of us on set, all with horns.
That's true.
You know, we're like, wait, hold on, we can't do it, we're stuck.
Yeah.
You know, we never got in a big table.
Very skilled team on the, you know, on the other side of it all.
How many chest pumps? I feel like you've mastered the chest pump.
There was a lot of chest pumping.
Yeah.
Yeah, there was a lot of hollering. I lost my voice a lot of times on...
Doing a chest pump?
Not doing the chest pump.
It was the screaming that goes along screaming. With it. Yeah.
Right.
There was a lot of screaming that went along with it.
I don't think I did any chest pumps.
I think he had the monopoly of chest pumps.
Yeah, I had the monopoly of chest pumps.
Yeah. Because I wouldn't have done it. As soon as I saw that you had taken the chest pump, I immediately thought, what should I do?
How do I top that?
Connell wanted peace.
You know who would make a good dark phase? The security guys that are hanging out with the other three actresses over there. I walked in, I was kind of nervous. There's a lot of security guys. Acting opposite someone like an Angelina when all of a sudden it's a process, is that, I know you guys do it often because you've acted with some big names, but I feel like it's got to be a little bit different level when it comes to her. Am I wrong?
Yeah, you're wrong. Yeah.
Well, just the hoopla that surrounds.
Nah, only in the sense that, like, you know, there's external things that we all know about each other. We know each other's history to an extent. But really, you know, we step in there as equals and to do the job. And I try and meet everyone, whether it's the craft services lady, the person making the coffee, to Angelina, to Chiwetel, you know, I greet them in the same way and wait to find out to take a human experience from them, and then that will inform how I greet them back. And Angelina's the same as everyone else in that regard, but also she just puts you at ease. She makes it feel completely normal and takes away any hoopla that potentially could have been there. I was terrified to work with Chiwetel. I was shaking.
I got to tell you, the first time I interviewed you, I was very intimidated and nervous too. I mean, you are on a different level.
Oh, so well, thank you.
Congratulations.
On a different level of intimidatingness.
No, just, I don't know if it's the British thing, the acting thing, it's a combo.
I missed you.
I feel like we actually have a lot in common. You're from Norway. I love Norway. you had, I think, a Disney song, When You Wish Upon a Star, at your wedding.
Yeah, yes.
Right?
Yes.
Mine was A Whole New World from Aladdin.
Well, there you go.
How do I hang in your circles? I don't get invited to any of this stuff. How do you become...
It's all a fairy tale.
Right.
You know?
Well, speaking of weddings, obviously in this film, Elle's character gets proposed to and they're planning a wedding, basically. What was the most stressful thing about yours?
I think for everyone, it's getting married is stressful, you know? And you're hoping it to be good. You hope the weather to be good. You hope, you know, there's so many moving parts, almost like making a movie, you know, or very much like making a movie, actually.
No.
Yes.
No.
I wasn't really asking.
Nor was I.
I read something about you, and they said that you specialize in spooky Disney sequels, you know, in light of Pirates and this. Is there something about these stories that you tend to gravitate toward?
Well, I think that they remind me a little bit of the kind of family movies that I grew up with, you know, in the end of the 70s, early 80s, and all of that. They are true world-creating stories, and I do like that, you know. That said, though, like at the end of the day, it is all about the characters. Yes, we need the spectacle. We need that, you know, it's a big budget studio movie, so it needs to be, you know, big. But I do love making stories for the big screen and tell, you know, the stories about these characters.
They posted something on the press kit for us to Back in Black, that AC/DC song, and it's kind of a time lapse of Angelina getting her thing. How long is that actual process?
I would say on every morning, probably like a 3 hour, 4 hour, I don't know, so something like that. So she starts very early, you know, and she comes in at probably around 5 a.m. or something like that, and then she has a crew call at 8, and, you know, here we go. So she has long days when she's going at it.
aren't you glad you're a guy? It'd probably take you maybe 25 minutes to get that stuff on, but when you're a woman.
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah, not all, yeah, it's, we also had guys in this movie that had to put on the prosthetics and the horns, and you'll see that, but.
Whatever.
Yeah.
But although they do look fantastic, the dark fays are great.
Maleficent is a threat to everyone. We'll do our best to protect you.
One of my favorite things is the thing in the closet that.
Isn't that creepy?
Creepy, yeah, but so I sort of love it.
It creeps me out. Yeah, I'd like to have it at home.
Kind of great, though.
Yeah, it'd be great to have.
You want one, don't you?
I want
sort of.
One of those mannequins.
You probably have one. I
might. You do.
If I were to walk into your closet right now, what's the coolest thing you have in there?
Oh, my closet's just a sliding glass door. I can't really walk into it. But, well, I have Marilyn Monroe's face cream and face powder.
What?
There you go.
Yeah. That's pretty cool.
Wow.
Yeah, the powder's still in there.
Very cool.
So you don't use
it.
No, I tried to. I got it at an auction.
Who do you know?
I got it at an auction. Yeah, when I was 7. I dressed up as Marilyn Monroe and went to the auction, trying on all her bras and everything.
That'll be in the biopic of you.
Yeah.
For sure.
Oh God, I have strange things. I have dirt from some of the countries I've been. Like, I have somebody gave me dirt from some. Yeah, but it's.
Are you allowed to bring that back?
No.
Yeah. No authority will see
this. There's so many things that have come out of my mouth right now, and I thought that was the safer answer. And it was wrong. And it was wrong.
I don't think I have anything terribly cool. Coolest thing in my closet.
Did you keep anything from your films? Do you have
I used to, kind of, and then I have this reluctance to hold on to memorabilia in any way, because I've always had this weird fear of living in the past.
Yes.
And I don't have posters or photographs, or I just don't have any of that sort of thing up. Sometimes I think, you know, you really should have kept that. But I, you know, sometimes, you know? You're the same?
Yeah, I'm the same. I don't have any.
Yeah.
Humans are hilarious.
I hope you enjoyed my cast interviews for the movie Maleficent, Mistress of Evil. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, and giveaways. In the meantime, I may have to help them clean this place up.